Another nanny's left, dear. Every nanny goes. We're unlucky, I suppose.
We are never going to find the perfect nanny.
Nonsense!
Precision and order, that's all that I ask. The running of a household, a straightforward task. The children, the servants, are all your domain. Well, I'm in the sovereign of Cherry Tree Lane.
Coats, the simple truth is that you've engaged six nannies in the past 4 months. They've all been unqualified disasters.
A nanny should govern, a nanny should rule. A nanny's a paragon who suffers no fool. A nanny's a stalwart, our children would gain by having such a nanny in Cherry Tree Lane.
Of course, George, but...
So take control of situations. Show your authority when interviewing staff. They know their role, they know their stations. Efficiency and forethought cuts the jobs in half. Briefcase!
I thought Katie Nana would be firm with the children. She always looked so cross.
Winifred never confused efficiency with a liver complaint. Umbrella!
If only we could find someone like your old nanny.
I'm afraid that's not realistic, my dear. Few women alive could stand in the standard stance of efficiency. Besides, we can never afford some of her caliber.
Precision and order, he was nothing less. Yes, and we're in the mess. No wonder that nannies are driven insane. We're living in a madhouse in Cherry Tree Lane.
Now, Winifred, if you do want to please me.
You know I do, George.
Very well. Then place me in advertisement in time, stating Jane and Michael Banks require the best possible nanny at the lowest possible wage.
We better read an odd before we make another mistake.
I will stress that.
Father!
What's that you're holding, dear?
We've read our own advertisement.
What's on?
Please, George, I think we should hear it.
Now, Winifred, none of your theatrics.
It won't hurt to listen.
Won't it? A nanny for two adorable children.
Adorable? Well, that's debatable, I must say.
If you want this choice position, have a gently disposition. Rosy cheeks, no warts.
That's the point I put in.
Play games, all sorts. You must be kind, you must be witty. Very sweet and very pretty.
Oh, of the ridiculous.
George, please.
Take us on outings, give us treats. Sing songs, bring sweets. Never be cross or cruel. Never feed us crops of oil or gruel.
Bleh!
Love us at the sun and your tub. And never smell of bloody water.
I'm a death of the two.
If you run scold and dominate us, we will never give you cause to hate us. We won't hide your spectacles so you can't see. Put toads in your bed or pepper in your tea. Hurry, Nanny. Many thanks, sincerely, Jane
and Michael Banks. One day. Now will you please go upstairs and let me get to work?
They were only trying to help.
It won't help anyone to make me late. Where's my hat?
George, dear.
Hat, hat, hat.
I thought I put it down here.
Hat.
I'm sure the bowler hat can't simply disappear.
Are all your domain.
Good morning.
Yes?
I've come and answered to the advertisement.
What advertisement? We even placed any advertisement. Not yet.
George and Winifred Banks live here, do they not?
Mr. and Mrs. Banks live here, yes.
And you are looking for a nanny?
Well, I suppose.
Very well then. Now let's see. Take us on outings, give us treats, which I most certainly can. Play games, all sorts.
Michael, it's an advertisement! Oh, but take it up with Mrs. Banks. She manages all that other side of things. Nothing domestic has anything to do with me. Oh, and don't forget the references.
I make it a rule never to give references.
But I thought... Shane and Michael want to say goodnight.
Tell them you've given me the message.
George, please.
Oh, Daddy, we had a fantastic day. We sang with a busker and danced with a statue. You wouldn't have approved, but...
If you know that, then why did you do it?
Can I have a kite, a proper one?
Could you fly it?
You can always teach me.
And when would I have time to do that?
Daddy, who is the father of Melius?
Now, would you please let me get on? Good night.
Poor Michael. All he cares about is flying kites.
I used to love flying kites when I was his age, but my nanny, Miss Andrews, soon beat it out of me.
I suppose we do need a new nanny, George. Is it out of the question to do without one?
Don't be absurd. Of course we need a nanny. All the best people have nannies so wives can do charity work and entertain. Which reminds me, how's your tea party coming along?
I'm not sure. It seems so odd to send out invitations to people I hardly know.
But they're people you should know. Remember, by your friends shall ye be judged.
But that's the point. They're not my friends.
Are you going to say something to Mary Poppins about this afternoon?
I don't think so.
Very well. Then make sure she's doing things our way, not hers. What good are rules if you can bend them? We need a nanny who is disciplined and stern. With boys and girls, you don't befriend them. I fear that Mary Poppins has a lot to learn.
Being Mrs. Banks should be an easy role, and yet it's one which I don't seem too good at. On the whole, I have a comfy home, I have a simple life, I have a name which tells the world I'm someone else's wife.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman.
Good morning. Great men have dreams of power and position, and it's our job to back them to the hilt. For shrewd investment and advice, they'll pay the price, the bedrocks on which banks are built. Banks, oh word, I see Herr von Hutter's coming in again today. Have you made your decision?
I believe so, sir.
Good, good. You sure it's the right one. What do you think? Money, of course.
Yes, but making money out of money. Is that enough?
Are you a man enough to be a banker? A man has dreams of building an empire to make his name in many distant lands. And in the new world, I am told, his soul strike gold will seize the jungle boom.
Decision, Mr. Banks. There's a town of good people whose future depends on you.
I know that.
Give us this chance. You won't regret it. The factory could be running in weeks and expanding before the year's out. Please, Mr. Banks, I'd give it everything I've got. Believe me.
I do believe you, Mrs. Northbrook. I've tried to find a way, but there's just not the collateral.
What about my workforce? Decent men who want a better life. They're my collateral. My men have dreams.
busy?
No, we're done. And no man should ever be too busy for his own children. What are you here for, young man? Have you come for some money as well?
Holly, what would they need money for?
Well, it's never too early to learn its value.
I know the value of this. 6 pence!
No, that's its worth. Its value is how you spend it. Do good, and may you have good luck.
And what do you say to Mr. Northbrook?
Thank you!
I'll wait outside.
What is the meaning of this? Really, Mary Poppins, I am not without a sense of humor.
Aren't you, Daddy?
No, I am not. But when I was a little boy, I would have never dared interrupt my father.
Were you ever a little boy?
Of course I was. But my nanny, Miss Andrew, kept me out of my father's way, and he'd have been very annoyed if she hadn't.
What about your mother?
I shouldn't think I saw either of them more than once a week.
Didn't they mind?
Mind? They were glad to be rid of me.
Then who kissed you goodnight, Miss Andrew?
Certainly not. There was no time for hugs and kisses and all that sobby nonsense. What's the matter?
Poor Daddy.
Poor? What do you mean, poor? That's maybe the man I am, eh, Mary Poppins?
Yes, I'm afraid it did.
That's enough. That's enough. You've seen where I work, and I have a great deal to do.
Daddy, when you invest the bank's money, what are you looking for? A good man or a good idea?
I suppose I should say a good idea, but a good man is much rarer and much more valuable.
Come along, children.
Mr. Von Hustler, I've considered your arguments, but I'm afraid my answer is no.
So you don't recognize a good idea?
Perhaps not, but I recognize a good man when I see one.
You'll regret this, Herr Banks!
Certain at this glance deserves a chance. Now, Miss Northbrook, when could the factory open?
Thank you, sir. You won't regret it.
George, what's happened? Are you ill?
No, should I be?
Of course not. Only why on earth are you home so early? Is everything all right?
No, everything is wrong.
My dear, what is it?
If you must know, I refused some German chaperone. It seems he went to our chief rivals. They gave him the money, and now it's turned to a gold mine.
Well, they can't expect you to get it right every time.
Can't they? That's exactly what they expect.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, if you say it loud enough.
That's more than loud enough. Go to your room.
But we were just...
I don't care what you were just. Upstairs, now. Where's my briefcase? My puttatia? Jane? Michael? Jane? Well, you give it to me. Must I put up with this behavior? You're the mother. Why can't you do something?
Well, I can try not shouting for a start.
Mary Poppins, you're here to teach the children manners. And just look at them. They're a pair of little savages. If I had my way, you'd be out of this house by...
George, you're tired. Mary Poppins, don't bring the children down tonight. Mr. Banks is quite exhausted. Perhaps you could keep them occupied.
I hope you haven't forgotten, ma'am. Tonight's my evening out.
What?
Oh, dear, I have forgotten. I suppose the best people wouldn't ask you to change your plans.
No, Mom, they wouldn't.
I thought not.
That's not fair! Daddy's mean, and Roy and I hate him!
Jane, take that back this instant. I will not have you criticize your father. Take the children upstairs, please, Mary Poppins. George?
What is it now?
I thought you might like to talk about it.
What would be the point?
Perhaps I can help.
The fact is, I've been suspended without salary until they decide what to do with me.
George, dear, you're going to be surprised.
When you're afraid, you know very well I hate surprises. It's the best of times.
Not this one. No, George, I do believe you're going to be proud.
But how bad is that? After so many years of good service, what's the worst that can happen?
When you're free to find to be dismissed by the bank, we'll be destitute. The servants will leave. The house will be repossessed. We'll be sitting outside with the children sitting on the frosty curbs.
We'll still have what really matters, the children and each other.
What's all this?
So we better make some plans. In fact, I'm afraid the time has come. I used to dream that when I grew up, I learned everything there was to know about the stars. Funny, I forgot all about that in years. I'm not usually sentimental.
It's good to look back sometimes.
Is it? I'm not so sure.
That is all it takes. It changes bread and water into Quadruple your present rate.
Well, close your mouth, George.